Hi students, a very pleasant and warm greetings to you all. Hope you all are doing good. In the last session, that is yesterday, we have seen about conditional statements in PHP, right? Conditional statements means we have seen about if condition, if else condition, that these are the statements, right? Conditional statements. So we can say it as if statement, if else statement, if else statement, and switch case. And the switch statement we have seen here in PHP. And today we are going to see the looping statement, okay? In JavaScript itself, we have learned this about this conditional statements and the looping statements. The same concept we are going to learn here in PHP. Only a slight modifications will be there in the syntax. If you learn the syntax properly, you know the concept already, right? So these chapters, this conditional statement, this looping statements and all will be very easy, since you have studied this in grade 11 itself. Okay, let's move on to our today's topic. Today's topic is looping statement. Okay, we are going to see about the looping statements in PHP.
Looping structure. From the word itself, what can you understand? Loop. Loop means something which is coming repeatedly or iteratively, right? Iterative, this word, iteration, this word you will be hearing in this chapter in many places. Okay, iteration is nothing but it means repeating or repetition. We'll say it as iteration. Okay, loop structure in this PHP, this loop structure will be a iterative control structure. Okay, this will execute the same block of codes in a many times. If you are giving some amount of time, at that much time that codes will be executed. Okay, this loops that iterate for a fixed number of time will be known as bounded loops. Okay, this PHP supports four types of loops. Okay, first one is for loop, for each loop, while loop, and do while loop. Okay, first let's see what is for loop. For loop means when you know how many times the code or the statement has to be executed or the block of statements have to be displayed. If you know that number of times, you can use this for loop. Okay, let's see the syntax for this for loop. Here they have given for, and then inside the bracket we'll have three steps or three blocks, right? Three segments are there. First one is init counter, next one is test counter, and then is increment counter. Okay, that init means it is nothing but initialization. Okay, initialization means initializing the loop's first value. The first value you have to give it here. If the number 1 to 5 you need to do the for loop for 1 to 5, that means 1 is the initial number, right? So here in this init counter, that is initialization counter, in this initialization you will be giving n is equal to 1. Okay, from 1 to 5 we need, right? So first one, init counter, initialization value is n is equal to 1. And then next one is test counter. Test counter means it is a condition. Okay, till 5 we need, right? So we have to give n less than or equal to 5. That like that you can give, or else you can give less than 6. That means till 5 you can get the value till 5, right? So this test counter means this is evaluated for every loop, every repetitive times, or this every iteration times. If it is true only, it will execute the next turn of loop. Understood? First, we have given the number as n is equal to 1, right? And it will process and it will check whether n is less than or equal to 5. That means if the number is 1, it will again execute the codes. And then again if the number is 2, again it will check whether the number is less than or equal to 5. And again it will execute. Likewise, till 5 it will execute. And when you get the value of 6, what will happen means n less than or equal to 5. This is the condition we have given here, right? This is the test counter we have given here. So when n is equal to 6, the result will be false, or the result will be negative, right? So the coding will not be executed. It will stop. Okay. And next one is increment counter. Here, they have given us increasing the loop counter value. Here we can give decrement or increment. Okay. Here we need 1 to 5. Right. I said you, we need 1 to 5. So, 1 we have given in the initialization value. If I give n plus plus in this increment counter value means, we'll get first value will be 1 and it will, and the test counter it will check whether it is less than 5. And in the increment counter, it will make the value 1 plus 1, that is 2, right? Again, the code will be executed and again it will check whether 2 is less than or equal to 5. Yes, again it will increment with 1. So, 2 plus 1, then the value will become 3. And again, it will increment and it will check the test condition and it will execute the code. Likewise, the process will be going on. This is the syntax for for loop. Okay, for loop, you'll have a bracket. Inside the bracket, you'll have three sections. First one is initialization. Next one is test, or you can say it is conditional segment. And the next one is increment. Okay. And after giving this for loop only, you can open this bracket and you can give the code or the statements which has to be executed, and you have to close the bracket also. Okay. See the example, then you will get the clear idea of this. Okay. First, PHP opening tag they have given, less than or symbol question mark PHP for, first what they have given, I is equal to 0. So the initialization happens here, initial value is 0 and then I less than or equal to 10. So the number will be 0 to 10. Okay. We need 1, 2, 3 likewise, right? So I plus plus increment is also, increment operator is also used here, and the statement they have given in the inside this for loop is echo the number is, and whatever comes in the value of I, it will be displayed. Okay. And then they have closed the for loop statements, that bracket, and then they have closed the PHP closing code. Okay. That is question mark and the greater than symbol. This is about for loop. Okay. We have seen the syntax and example for for loop. Okay. For this for loop, they have given a flow chart. Okay. Flow chart or the structure also. See this diagram. They have given the initial action. That is, first the initialization. The value is I is equal to 0. And then the condition. Condition will be giving in this rhombus or this diamond box, right? So I less than 100. That will be a condition. So this, whether this loop want to continue or this loop have to end, that will be decided by this conditional box only. Okay. Next one is the statement. If the condition is true or if the condition is accepted, then the statement or the codings which is inside the for loop will be executed. So the statements, and then again it will come for iteration, that is increment or decrement. It will increase one value and again it will check the condition, and again if the condition is true, the statements or the codes will be executed, or if the condition is false, the process will end. Okay, this is the flowchart for loop. Okay, next we are going to see for each loop. Okay, for each means this is this one you won't have seen in Java and all, right? For loop, while loop, do while loop, you have seen in Java. This for each loop is exclusively for PHP only. Okay, this mainly this is used for looping through the value of array. Okay, in the last chapter we have seen about arrays. When you are using an array, inside this array, if you need a for loop, we'll use this for each loop. Okay, the loop iteration will depend on each key value which is inside the array. Okay, for each loop iteration, the value of the current array element will be assigned to the variable value. Okay. And so what will happen? The array pointer will be increased one by one till it reaches the end of the array. Okay. When you are using the array element, we'll use this for each loop. Okay. See the syntax for that. For each. For loop, we used for. Here, for each. Inside the bracket, array as value. We have to give the array and then you have to give as. And then the value. And then open the bracket and write the code or the statements to be executed and then close the bracket. Okay, that's all about this for each loop. Okay, this for each construction, this for each structure will provide a easy way to get the iterations over array. When you are having the array, this for each loop will give the output easily. Okay, this works only on arrays and objects. Okay, and this will issue an error when you use it on normal, in a normal variable you have to use only what, for loop. If you use a for each structure in normal variable, it will give you a error, okay, with different data type or uninitialized variable, like that some errors may come when you use this for each loop for a single variable. Okay, for a single variable we have to use what, for loop, and if it is an array we have to use for each loop. Okay, for this for each loop we'll see one example. First you have opened the PHP tag and then student name is equal to array of, they have given Maggie, Nini and Nalini, Nilani, Sibi, Shini, like this they have given some names. These are arrays. Okay, inside this array they have given a name, and for each we are writing the for each loop here. Inside that you are giving student name as value. Okay, and then inside that we are going to write whatever want to be executed or whatever statements have to be displayed, we have to give inside this bracket. Okay, and then the PHP code has been entered. Okay, next one is while loop. While loop means this executes a block of codes till the condition specified in the while statement. Okay, this is little similar like other loops, like a for loop and all. Here while, then one condition will be there. If the condition is true, then the code or the statement given below will be executed. Okay, and if the condition is false, that won't be executed. Okay, first the initialization value will be there, and then while will have a condition. While, along with while itself, will have a condition in the bracket, and then the statement or the code to be executed will be given. Okay, do while means first it will do. It is similar as the while loop only, but it will execute the block at least once. Okay, do while, first you have seen while. While this condition is true, this has to be executed. Here do while means first it will do and then it will check the condition. Do while this condition is correct. Likewise, this do while will be. Okay, see this diagram, so we'll get an example. See, first the loop will start and whatever we are giving, whatever code we have given will be executed, and then it will check for the condition. While condition will be there. In the syntax also they are given, you can see in your book in page number 115. Okay, syntax, do, and then the code or the statements to be executed, and then the while condition will be there. While of in the bracket condition will be there. If the condition is true, it will again execute the code or the statement, and if the condition is false or if it does not satisfy the specific condition, the loop will be stopped. Okay, that is do while loop. Okay, while loop means first it will check the condition. If the condition is true, the statement will be executed. If the condition is false or if the condition is not satisfied, it will stop or exit the loop. Okay, and they have given example also. For while loop, they have given an example as student count is equal to 10. Student number equal to 1. Okay, while student number is less than or equal to student count, like that they are given. First it will check this condition. If this condition is accepted or if this condition is true, it will execute. The student number is, and the number will be displayed. Okay, and then they have given the increment operator. So the student number, if first student number is 1, if this one will be executed and the student number will become 2. Increment operator is there, right? So it will add 1 to it, and again it will check the condition. While student number is less than or equal to student count. So this will check this condition. Again, if this condition is accepted or if this condition is true, if the student count is greater than the student number only, then again this, the student number is, then the next number will be displayed. Okay, why this next number will be displayed? Here they have given the valued. Can you see this dollar symbol? This dollar symbol we have studied in the first lesson when you started the learning this PHP itself. Dollar means it is a variable, right? So the value of this student number will be displayed in this place. Okay, this is about while loop. Do while loop, in this example also they have given student count is equal to 10, student number is equal to 1. First it will do, what it will do? Do, inside there some codings are there, so this codes will be executed. The student number is, and the number will be displayed. And then next it will increment 1, and then it will check for the condition, whether the condition is satisfied. If the condition is satisfied, again it will do, again it will display the number, the student number is and the number, and again it will increase, and then it will check whether the condition is accepted, right? This is the difference between while loop and do while loop. From the word, from the while structure or do while structure, from that word itself you can say while means while this condition is true, the code or the statements will be executed. Do while means first it will do, or first it will execute the statement or the codes, and then it will check for the condition. Do and then while this condition. While means while this condition is true, this has to be executed. Okay, understood the difference between while loop and do while loop? That's all in this chapter. Here we have seen the loop structure, right? In this loop structure we have seen for loop, for each loop, while loop and do while loop, right? For loop means we have seen three sections inside for loop. For loop has, so at first one is initialization, that is initializing counter. Then next one is condition, that is test counter. And the next one is increment counter, increment or decrement, I plus plus, I minus minus, this all will come under this increment counter. Okay, so this for loop has three sections or three segments: initialization, condition and increment. Okay, for each loop means same as for loop. For loop will be used for variables. If we have to use this for loop for arrays, we will use for each. Okay, for each of the array element, likewise they have named it. Okay, for means we'll have a single variable, and for that variable this for loop will be used. If array means it will have many variables inside the array, right? Array means it is a collection of variables or a collection of characters, right? So inside the array it will have more than one variable. So for each we are using this for loop for variable, and for each for arrays. Okay, next one is while and do while. While means while this condition is true, then the coding or the statement will be executed. Do while means first the statement will be executed. First it will do the set and the statement will be executed, and then it will check for the condition. Okay, and then only it will we have to write the while condition. Okay, if you get the clear idea about this, you can write the syntax and also the example by your own. Okay, just see the book once, so see and read the syntax and the example, see it once, and you will get a clear idea about it. Okay, if you have any doubts in this looping structure or conditional statement when you are reading itself, if you have any doubts, just call or just text in our group and ask me. Okay, so that will be clear with this conditional statement and looping structure. This is the basic things to do a big program. Okay, so that's all in this looping structure. Okay, looping structure and conditional statements, learn it today itself. Okay,
we have come to the end of the chapter. You would have got a clear idea about looping structure, right? Here we have seen for loop, for each loop, while loop and do while loop, right? We have seen the syntax and example for these looping structures. Next session we are going to learn about forms and files. Okay, before that you make sure you read the whole chapter and you write down all the headings and the syntax and examples for each conditions or each statements. Okay, both the conditional statements and looping structure, both the chapter, write it down in your note and write all the headings. We have seen if statement, if else statement, if else statement, switch statement in conditional statements, right? In looping structure today we have seen for loop, for each loop, while loop and do while loop. Put all these headings and write down the syntax and examples for that. Okay, you can write your own examples also. You don't need to write whatever is given in the book. You can write, you can create your own examples. You know the syntax, your syntax is given there in the book, right? See the syntax, learn and write down the syntax and create your own example and write it down and send it to me. Okay, thank you for your valuable time. Stay home, stay safe, take care, bye.